I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Welcome to 10 Minutes. I'm Tony Scott. Peter today.
No, hey.
How are you doing, Todd Houck?
I'm well. Thank you for having me. I really appreciate being here. I'm so excited.
Cameo appearance this week.
Trying to.
Why do you think we are having you on the show versus Peter today?
I'm prettier.
That for sure.
Yep.
That for sure. Maybe it's because you're the only guy on the staff who saw boys hockey last week.
Possibly.
And we and Peter and I both saw lots of girls. We went to that Andover game and went to the, we had obviously hosted the
Danglefest. Yeah, right.
So we'll be experts in the girls 10 minutes show, but if we bring you in, you broadcasted the, the lion's share of the games up in Moorhead. You could comment on the Moorhead. So we've got you in here talking about boys hockey today.
Let's do that. Let's get this rolling.
Let's rock and roll it. Speaking of rocking and rolling, our sponsor is pretty much a rock and roll show.
Always rolling.
Hockey over at Map South.
Mendota Heights.
Talked to some of those guys this week. They're just wrapping up their fall training for their guys. They're getting ready for next year. Tons and tons of stuff going on there. Girls program, boys program, high school program, junior program, and of course Eric Rasmussen with the pros.
The Raz, yep.
What a great program over there. What an unbelievable facility that they have over there, and great trainers. So if you're looking to get up your game and you live in that side of town, Map South Hockey points you in the right direction.
Oh, I like that segue.
Like that?
Yeah, beautiful.
All right, Squirt Hockey is just underway. Our Squirtacular teams.
Oh, dear goodness.
72 of them this year will be making their way to Blaine.
That's A's and B's, not just a lot of.
We got teams coming from the UP, Arizona, Illinois. It's going to be a blast of a tournament this year.
My headaches are right now, but we'll be fine.
The hardest part of this tournament was turning some teams away.
Oh, yeah, it was. That was the tough part.
Nice. But
breaking up is hard to do.
They're getting their, the teams are getting their pin orders done now. If you need a pin order, check out the Steelberry folks. They're a great partner of ours. This year, we're going to have a YHH pin for sale, and all of the proceeds from the YHH pin will go. The profits from the pin will go to the Sandwich Project.
Sandwich Project, yeah. Good, good charity.
And then speaking of that, Hockey Day, Hockey Helpers is in December. Check out the Sandwich Project MN. There's two spots still available for that at the 9 o'clock hour on December 6th, so check that out. Lots to talk about. Let's talk about some hockey now.
Yeah, let's get into those peewees. Let's go from squirts right to the next level peewees.
Biggest surprise I saw last week, Peewee Double A, Shakopee.
Okay? Shocks.
The Shock Town
Shocktown.
Beats Minnetonka. Did you ever think you'd hear those words? Shakopee beats Minnetonka and Peewee Double A?
Anything can happen in D6, even though everybody kind of sees Edina and EP and Tonka. But
and Chaska.
Chaska Chan, yeah, true.
I mean, it's a tough district, and Shakopee gets their first big D6 win. Congratulations to them. Moorhead, the PBAA team that no one's seen, they're like a ghost.
They're
a
ghost.
You just can't haven't seen them yet.
They're on the blip on the map.
But they're still number two in the state. They just keep hovering at the number two spot. We think they're going to be really good. We hear they're coming to town.
I know.
Santa.
Super.
Not this weekend, but the following weekend, the 23rd weekend. The Squirt A's, the PBAA's, and the Bantam AA's will be making their way through the Twin Cities.
Super excited.
I'm sure YHH will make their way out to the rink to see one, two, or all three.
Well, it's funny because I just saw them all last week, and so now they're finally coming back to see me.
Finally to come back to see us. All right. And last peewee note, congratulations to Spring Lake Park. They go 4-0 in their home tournament. They beat Osseo Maple Grove's A-team 2-1 in OT, so congratulations to the Panthers on their big championship
win. Good win.
Let's talk for a few minutes on the Bantam AA Blue Ox tournament last weekend in Moorhead.
Moorhead.
Obviously, Hermantown won it. Who'd you pick to win it? Yeah. You picked Hermantown.
I did. I mean, I wanted to go with the hometown team. I thought Moorhead was going to be. I was lucky enough to see those guys as well as Hermantown. A lot of those guys playing on the North team this summer with the Bantam Elite.
Both teams.
So, I mean, it was like, holy cow, which one you chose. But Hermantown really was just, they have two such strong lines with Zamplant and Wyatt Carlson and their little brother Max. So it was, it was definitely a battle for all ages when it came down to them in the Spuds.
Is there any surprise you get the Bantam Elite League? You have four or five kids from the Moorhead team and four or five. Is it any surprise that they actually met in the championship game?
I think it was a little bit of a surprise. I think everybody really had Minnetonka.
I thought so.
Minnetonka
too.
Was a two seed coming into it. They just didn't quite get it together on Friday. So they
lost to Sanford Power.
Yep, they did. So Sioux Falls.
Oh, yeah, Sioux Falls.
There might be powered by Sanford.
Yeah.
But anyway, I think the best thing about it was I got so used to seeing these kids, onesies and twosies, with their elite team. Yeah. And now you get them all together. So Hermantown and Moorhead both got that community feel. So when they play together, it definitely is the bros who've been together since they were mites. And so there's definitely a lot of cohesion with those guys.
And a great atmosphere in the rink. I was watching your broadcast on Sunday, and the crowd, when Moorhead would score, would just go bananas.
I mean, it was lined up all the way around on the dad section, as I always call it, right behind the net. I mean, there was no place to stand there.
Standing room only.
It was awesome.
Cool.
Great.
Oh, was it cold?
Nope.
Bushy?
Nope. Bushy was great.
Really?
You could be there.
Did you broadcast indoors or outdoors?
I was outdoor.
In the elements. Indoor guy.
Elements.
I'm a bit soft, if you know what I mean.
And silent producer Justin, he did not bring his Carhartt, so it wasn't that cold.
So he was outside, huh?
He was outside as well. We bear the elements.
All right. Zam Plant, congrats to him. MVP the new record. I mean, he smashed the record. Jax Murray had the record from the first Blue Ox in 2013. He's now skating in Arizona State. Zam breaks the record with 19 points.
Yep, and he had 16 going into the championship game. He had 3 assists in the chip, so kudos to Zam. And
you're driving home. I didn't see the entire game. You're driving home from Moorhead, and I'm like, who'd you give the MVP to? And you said, Zam Plant. You didn't give it to Wyatt Carlson? He had 2 hat tricks in the semis and the finals. He goes, Tony, look at the points.
Did
you watch the games? I'm like, oh, sorry. So any more comments on Zam's performance?
I think one of the most compelling things about Zam, it's not just the stats and it's not just the victories. It's like he really is a great player and a great team player. Like, they goofed around. We tried to do the interview with Wyatt Carlson, which we didn't put on the YHH Twitter, which I tried to interview Wyatt, and all of a sudden he comes out and he had a bottle of water ready to dump onto Wyatt.
Oh, yeah.
So then all of a sudden I'm like, oh, if I get wet, so help me, Wyatt. So I started talking to him a little bit about the game. Next thing you know, him and 5 other guys all come with water bottles, just doused Wyatt Carlson. So
after the interview?
During our interview. So we had to retake it.
Oh,
but I have
no.
The video of it when he gets doused. Here he is just sweating. Goal guy, the net guy are waiting for us.
I was wondering why.
He was all slick, but that they have such charisma and they have such a great bond with those guys. So
that was a good deal.
So Zam is just kind of the straw that stirs that team, but they all really are great friends. And so that's fun to see.
All right, last Bantam note, the Tui Dinas, white and green playoff this weekend. They clash, they'll play a couple times, D6 games. We'll take a peek at that this weekend as we prepare for our Gobbler tournament.
Gobble, gobble.
And we've had, the Dinah teams have had quite a bit of success. It's almost like an Edina Invitational to Gobbler.
Yeah, it's only 15 minutes away.
They've done so well in the tournament. So we'll take an eye on those guys. We'll try to get as much PBB and Bantam B action in here in the next 10 days so we can get prepped and know who the top teams are heading into the tournament. The brackets for the Gobbler came out
yesterday.
Nice, even, a lot of D6 teams. So sorry, the D6 teams who have to play D6, but when you have 3 pools and 5 teams,
hey, no more than 2 per pool. So we spread them out.
Yeah,
and they're spread out.
But it looks like a good field. Matamidi was number 1 in Bantam B's, and they'll be a top seed in one of the pools. And obviously, we expect the Edinas and Minnetonkas to do well, and hope for a. I'm hoping to see Hastings do well. Too.
I'd like to see Hastings.
Team,
nobody will give them love because it's all the D6. So
I would love it.
Anybody comes in non-6, never know.
Love it. Love to see it. All right, let's switch gears. We did our first high school hockey boys podcast.
Oh yes, yes.
And Carl, you know, the guru maven comes out with a top 10. I'm not sure if he was trolling or not because his top 10 was not exactly his
top 4
best.
Was good.
Yeah, he got his top 4 pretty good. He had EP, Benilde St. Margaret's, and over Rosemont. I think those are four heavyweights.
I got those.
And then I don't mind Maple Grove. You know, you can go on some past performance, but what you gotta realize, Maple Grove doesn't have Brock Faber or Brendan Reller and Justin Janicki, Connor Kelly. Those guys aren't there. I mean, I think they're a top 10-ish team. They're still pretty deep, but 5? I'm not sure that's right yet. Okay, and then he's got Minnetonka at number 6.
Where?
Yeah, it's 6.
Okay.
I'm not sure Tonka's quite there, but, you know, prove me wrong, I guess, you know.
Was there Red Bull in the room when he made the picks?
He wasn't there. He was up in Duluth. So.
Well, I'm saying in his room.
Must be something in the water.
Something in the water. It's not frozen yet.
Who knows? Who knows? So you make some comments on Carl's top 10. Carl never watches our show, so it doesn't matter. We can just dagger him all we want. He'll never even see it.
Carl who?
Yeah, Carl who? All right, here's a fun question for you. High school hockey's on the return, right?
Yep. Right around the corner.
Let's name one player. Maybe you've seen him a lot, or you haven't seen him, but you're really looking forward to seeing him play, maybe for their last time or for the first time in high school hockey. Who's your guy?
My guy's got to be Blake Biondi. I've heard so much about him, and I know he's been in the Metro, but just haven't had a chance to actually see him in action on ice. I mean, we've talked about Hermantown. I saw the Bantams this weekend, but he's on the cover of magazines, so it's like I want to see him in person, see if he is everything that everybody's talking about. We talked about it. You see stats. I just want to see him skate. I mean, I know he's a good player. I just want to see it for myself.
He's all that. That's for sure. So I'm going to go the other way. You're going with a senior outgoing guy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going with a sophomore incoming guy. You and I have seen this guy, I don't know, a couple hundred times probably play, Jackson Blake. But we've not seen him play at the high school level.
No, we have not.
He did quite well in the high school elite league this past fall. I'm really looking forward to seeing him now as he's grown up. You know, he's 5'9", 5'10", now, so he's full grown. He's not
towering over his dad.
He's not a tiny little guy anymore. He can play. He's still got the speed. He's got the skill. He's on a team that's going to be it's kind of a dream team type team in Prairie this year. So
yes. That's
the one guy I'm looking forward to seeing play this year.
And Dad's a former Spud, where I just came
former
from.
Former Spud, oh yeah.
How about that connection?
Oh yeah, it all
comes back
circle
together.
Of life, right?
Circle of Spuds.
There it is. All right, let's get to our Boom Roasted. It's your turn. It's your turn. You're going to do the Roasted.
I'm a roast.
And you're going to do the puck today.
Okay, I'll do my best. All right, start with the Boom Roast. And this Boom Roast goes, because obviously it's an experience I had during the weekend. So coaches, if you have an issue with something that happened during a game, I understand you're frustrated. Mm-hmm. I understand you want to go look at the rule book. I know you want to have somebody listen to you. You want to talk to the tournament director. But don't go off.
That was you, by the way.
Was me. Sometimes I was really, really available. Sometimes I was a broadcast booth, or I wore a lot of different hats. But don't go off on the volunteer that's there. They're there. They're helping us keep the tournament going smoothly. There's no reason that somebody who's there volunteering, just doing their job, and you got to go off on them and let them know every single thing that you're frustrated with. So my Boom Roast would be like, lay off the volunteers, leave a message.
Bring it to you.
The TD will get back to you. Trust me.
Yeah, we will. All right, there's a boom. There's a boom. All right, let's go favorites, and then we'll get to our game puck.
Oh.
Favorite mascot.
Favorite mascot.
You got a mascot? You want me to go first?
You go first in this one.
I like the disarming mascot.
Oh, yes.
You know, the ducks, the frogs.
Ribbit.
Spuds.
Yes.
Anything that's like disarming. You know, like I love those ones. Those just kind of crack me up. So if I had to pick one, I'm going to go with the TCU Horn Frogs. Because it's a frog, but man, that thing's got horns on it. It's gonna get you.
It's going to get you. You know, I thought about, should I just pick a particular one? Like, do I pick an eagle? Do I pick a bear? But I really like mascots.
How about weather?
Storms are nice.
Storm or lightning.
But I like mascots that have some history behind them. For example, the Spuds are the Spuds because that part of the state used to be a really heavy potato farm.
Still is.
Growing up as a kid, I grew up in Austin, so we're known as the Packers.
Yeah.
Not because of the Green Bay Packers, but because of Hormel and the Meat Packers.
Right.
And so we had a butcher on our jerseys.
A little bit of history.
So there's a history of the community.
Culture.
The culture that makes up who they are and where they are as a community. So that's my, I mean, you even make fun of the Skippers. As much as we want to diss the Skippers,
but
they're on the lake and it's the Skipper, so it's got some heritage because Lake Minnetonka does make up the community. So that's where I go with my mascots.
I like that one. All right, it's good. Good answers. All right, last one. You got your puck?
I do. I have a game puck, which YHH Puck is going to go to. And I want to bring this out real quick because Mr. Rob Grammer was part of the ribbon cutting. I'll get a nice picture here of the third rink up at the Cullen Center up in Moorhead. So Rob Graham did so much for that Grammer.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes when you know him, you just call
him
Graham. Just Graham. Because everybody goes Grammer.
Yep.
But Grammer is the best because he's executive director of Moorhead Youth Hockey. He's done so much for that community. Growing up in the community, staying there in the community, and making it where it is. He's trying to get that third rink, and he was successful. They had a great ribbon cutting. So kudos to you, Rob, and the great things you're doing up in Moorhead.
Kudos to you too, Todd, for making this show happen. Thanks to our sponsor, Map South, for supporting our programming, not just here with 10 Minutes, but all the other stuff. We really appreciate the people from Map South Hockey. Appreciate you too, Todd.
Thank you. Good night.
See you at the rink.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.